Tom here from Lauren Systems, and Plex has been used as part of a DDoS attack for about 37,000 vulnerable servers. Hopefully you are not one of them. If you didn't know about this incident, please update your Plex and make sure you are running the latest version, which mitigates this. Now, what I want to discuss is a couple things. One, anytime I mention self-hosting a service and then exposing said service to the internet, first, do you really need it exposed is the first question. I know it's greatly convenient just to throw it online and use your public IP space so you can get to it remotely. I often suggest, whenever possible, putting these things behind a VPN to help mitigate these potential issues because you're limiting your threat surface. But if you do have it out here, you may be part of a botnet if you don't configure it properly. And we're going to talk about a couple scenarios here and exactly how Plex was used in a DDoS attack, and well, briefly touch on what a DDoS attack is in case you don't know. Before we dive into the details, let's first... If you'd like to learn more about me or my company, head over to lawrencesystems.com. If you'd like to hire a short project, there's a hires button right at the top. If you'd like to help keep this channel sponsor-free, and thank you to everyone who already has, there is a join button here for YouTube and a Patreon page. Your support is greatly appreciated. If you're looking for deals or discounts on products and services we offer on this channel, check out the affiliate links down below. They're in the description of all of our videos, including a link to our shirt store. We have a wide variety of shirts that we sell, and new designs come out, well, randomly, so check back frequently. And finally, our forums. Forums.lawrencesystems.com is where you can have a more in-depth discussion about this video and other tech topics you've seen on this channel. Now, back to our content. Now, today is February 15th, 2021, and I bring that up because Plex Media servers are actively being used and abused by DDoS for Hire service as a UDP reflection amplification vector and a distributed denial of service attack. But what we don't have any evidence of is that any data was exfiltrated or any other further compromise of your network came from this particular attack. That's what we know now, and that's an important factor. I know a lot of people probably want to have an understanding of is whether or not this means their system was compromised in a way where someone was inside their network and was, you know, exfiltrating data, or potentially what would be the worst case scenario, like a lateral movement and get further into something more than just Plex. To our knowledge, this was only abusable based on the ability to DDoS and not actually compromise any of the data. So you basically, your Plex server becomes an unwilling or unwitting participant in the abuse and the sending out of all these extra packets, but not actually compromise any data. They're just bouncing data off of it, bouncing some packets off of it. Now, these are the ports you need to turn on to open up Plex. And a lot of you are probably going, I don't do this. I don't open up these ports. Clearly wasn't me. But here's where something that's really important needs to be thought about. If you're using a more advanced firewall, such as the PF Sensor on Tangle, which I've covered a lot of on this channel, those firewalls both have UPnP turned off by default. But if you're using whatever was provided to you by your ISP, or you have a consumer firewall, those frequently have UPnP turned on by default. So it's on many of those, meaning if you just load Plex and it talks UPnP to your consumer router, it just opens up the ports for you for convenience. Matter of fact, according to Bleeping Computer, there's 27,000 conveniently open Plex servers with this particular problem. Now, there is a patch for it. The first immediate thing is if you can turn UPnP off, turn it off. I say if, because I know some routers, some of the consumer ones, don't even seem to have the option to actually turn it off. But you could always just stop Plex and not be part of this potential service problem. Now, why do they use UDP? And let's talk about that really quickly here. With a distributed denial of service attack, UDP is very ideal because you can lie about where you want the destination to go. So let's look at this graphic over on the Baidu Labs write-up, where we have a threat actor who sends a packet to one of these Plex servers or the amplifiers to get to the victim. The goal is to flood the target with so much data they cannot process it. UDP is very ideal because I can send a packet, but instead of the packet returning to me, it can go, hey, where is the return address of this packet? And we give the victim as the return. The amplification factor is because you only have, as the attacker, so many bots at your disposal. And maybe you have enough bots to send a bunch of packets to the victim. That creates two problems. One, It's a matter of how much traffic can the target take and how many bots do you have, and the other issue of they can now see my bots sending traffic. That's a problem. But when we can use those bots to reflect, and this is what Plex is offering them, we can reflect. Not only are we obscuring where the original traffic came from, we're also amplifying. And according to researchers over at NetScout, attacks abusing this UDP reflection amplification attack vector by targeting PMSSDP, the Plex Media Server Reflectors Amplifiers, have an amplification ratio of 4.68 to 1. That means for each bot they have, the bot can hand these packets over to the Plex servers, who then amplify this attack at 4.68 to 1 for the packets in, meaning you're going to get a lot more data out of them than you put in, which is the exact ideal. So first we've obscured who the bots are because they're bouncing them off of these Plex servers, and then these Plex servers are sending 4.68 packets to each packet sent on average, meaning we get quite an amplification and a confusion because this is spread across 27,000 exposed Plex devices, and we don't know where the attack came from exactly. It becomes very tricky to trace this down when you're dealing with something at this scale. So all the victim sees is all of a sudden all these random 27,000 devices are now attacking my system. Now 27,000 is what we know about. There might be even more. These companies frequently use tools like their own scanning or something like Shodan to try to find all the servers, and the bots are really efficient at constantly making lists of the exposed, known, and vulnerable servers to add them to their list of tools they used or their booter services arsenal, as it was put here. There's actually a few other articles linked over here at the bottom of Bleeping Computer, which I'll leave a link to, that talks about some of the other tools they're using. And this is frequently how these denial of service companies, if you want to refer to them as that, illegal businesses, if they're really a business, DDoS for hire groups, we'll just call them that. And they build a list of all the different bots they have and then each thing they can reflect off of then to attack a victim. And it's not just one thing. This is just one more thing added to their list. Now, this has been ongoing for a little while. This is not necessarily a new attack. And it's unfortunate. It may have been a mystery when some people, well, all of a sudden my internet's slow for periods of time. Yes, whenever they're using it, they're using your internet and bandwidth, which may have its own consequences with data caps and things like that, because suddenly you're just massively sending out all kinds of data using up your data cap in this DDoS for hire. Mitigations against this. If you don't need to publicly expose something, don't do it. If you can keep it behind a VPN, you're that much safer because you've reduced your threat surface. Update Plex. That's obviously the immediate thing. If you need to have this publicly exposed, and what you need to do to fix it immediately is just, well, update Plex. Don't use a consumer router where you can't turn UPnP off because, well, it being on is undoubtedly what led to the majority of these. I doubt 27,000 people took the time to port forward their Plex. It's, like I said, more likely UPnP was in use and just did it automatically for them. So I'll leave links to all this so you can read up on it. It's an interesting article. It's an interesting thought process of whenever you self-host things, making sure that you're aware that these risks are always there on any time you publicly expose things. And it's important to keep up with patches and updates, as is always stated on here. And this is one more reason to run a non-consumer grade firewall in your environment so you don't have things like UPnP turned on. And if you did turn them on, really question if you need it, because it allows anything to start talking to it. And just because it was on a separate network, that may mitigate some lateral movement if you've got things subdivided out in your network, but it doesn't mitigate the fact that your bandwidth was used to participate in potential attacks like this. All right, and thanks. And thank you for making it to the end of the video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more content from the channel, hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon if you'd like YouTube to notify you when new videos come out. If you'd like to hire us, head over to lawrencesystems.com, fill out our contact page, and let us know what we can help you with and what projects you'd like us to work together on. If you want to carry on the discussion, head over to forums.lawrencesystems.com, where we can carry on the discussion about this video, other videos, or other tech topics in general. Even suggestions for new videos, they're accepted right there on our forums, which are free. Also, if you'd like to help the channel out in other ways, head over to our affiliate page. We have a lot of great tech offers for you. And once again, thanks for watching, and see you next time.